Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another segment of Fun and Games. My name is Michelle Stone.
I'm Jenna Rose.
And we are with the Underground Music Collective. Today, we are joined by a pretty awesome guest. You want to go ahead and introduce yourself?
Hello, everybody. My name is Sonny Dayes. I'm from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. And yeah, I'm really happy to be here.
Yeah, Mr. Sonny came on my radar actually online. I came across his profile. I found it very uplifting and positive and fun to watch. So I gave him a follow. He gave me a follow back. We met and the rest is history. Yeah. So today actually not only is a cool episode with Sonny, but it's actually his birthday. Woo! Insert cheers. So be sure to leave some happy birthday comments. He will look at those. We did get some cupcakes here for him. Jenna, you want to tell him what flavor cupcake we got here?
These are, I believe, vanilla with buttercream frosting and chocolate garnish.
Yum, and we do also have us a little champagne here.
We do.
So we're going to have ourselves a little cheers. If you're watching this right now, I know you're at home and you're drinking some wine, some water, beer, whatever, have a cheers with us.
Cheers to Sonny.
Cheers. Happy birthday. Cheers. Thank you. Oh. I'm 26.
So Sonny, let's get right down to it. Let's talk about what you're doing, you know, because I definitely know a lot about the stuff that you're involved in. I know you have your TikToks where you're kind of making cool videos and you're definitely going out and putting yourself out there and playing. We saw you play with Neon Leaf Media where you were on the rooftop. Mm-hmm. Tell everyone like kind of your projects that you're really focusing on right now. I know you just came out with two new singles. Is that right?
I came out with an album in February and then a single in July after that. And right now I'm working on a second album and finishing up the songwriting for that and starting to record demos. But I'm definitely looking to work with a producer, and I'm kind of looking around for the right people and gonna record the demos myself like I did before, but definitely taking a more, not necessarily more professional approach, but I would really like to get in the studio and have, you know, somebody else's ideas push the music forward and not really just do everything myself like I did all through the pandemic with the first album, Enjoy the Rain, and then the new single after that. Those were definitely really fun to do, and through that time I was learning to record and built a home studio back in Philly, and it was a great thing to do and such a blessing to have a home studio in my apartment there that was dead enough and able to record really good tracks. And because through the pandemic, we were all at home. So I was just really, you know, I'm really grateful to be able to have that time and to learn, but I'm ready to, you know, move into studios and do it that way too.
Yeah. So I know we've kind of talked about it, the name Sonny Dayes. That's not actually your name. It's not his name. If you want to know what his name is, you'll just have to look at his music and talk to him and find out. Or you can tell him. But tell everyone like kind of how you came up with the name Sonny Dayes.
So I've always wanted an alias for some reason. And I've always wanted to be an artist since I was a kid and be a singer-songwriter. And it just really took a lot of thought. And then I just kind of tried to really think about what, you know, my message is and the type of what fits me as a person. And it's kind of happy-go-lucky, you know, it's the double meaning. It's kind of a pun, the Sonny Dayes. And it's kind of something, you know, it's kind of cute. It makes people smile. And I just came up with it because I really wanted to express who I am and the kind of music that I make. And it's not all happy and, you know, super like acoustic hype type of stuff. It's a lot of it's kind of sad, but I have a really positive outlook in life that I got from my mother. And
shout out mom.
Yeah. Shout out mom. Thanks for that. Just a really positive outlook on life and about everything. I think that's really important. And I try to share that with my music. And I try to write things that would make me happy too. And, you know, a lot of the songs are personal, some are not, but it's always kind of trying to be a sunny day, you know, outside to my listeners and whoever chooses to listen to music, you know.
So even if there's rain, there's still a sunny day coming.
Oh, yeah. By the way, guys, we are here to play a game because this is fun and games.
Woo!
So here we play games while we interview, just, you know, because why not? So today we're playing Jenga, which is an OG fun and games game. It was one of the first games that we played, and everyone knows how to play Jenga. I mean, well,
apparently not, because we've had some rule bending.
Yeah, well, I guess everyone's not clear on the rules, but rules aren't meant to be broken. So Sonny, you want to go ahead and start and maybe move your drink out of the way so we don't have any spills in the studio.
Yeah.
We have a whole table full of food.
Hope you don't mind if I eat during the interview.
Yes, oh, of course. Yes. We want you to.
We're fans of ASMR here. Yeah, so.
We love it. We might do a whole ASMR episode, nice, mess around and
nice,
get wild.
Just eating, crunching. Yeah. Make sure I get right up on the mic crunching these delicious
That's
carrots.
Exactly what you see. Look at him. He's an expert.
This is what the people want.
Oh, you gotta put it on top.
Yeah.
That's part of it too. A lot of people don't know, but part of Jenga is making sure the piece you pull out can go on top, which is a whole part of the, some people make it fall by putting it on top. So
positivity is not just your message in your songs, but it's also how you kind of try to live your life.
Yeah.
And the direction you want to take things. Can you tell us about that a little bit, what that means to you?
Yeah. So, you know, I think that positivity is always looking at the bright side of things. And I think that's really important, that even, you know, even when bad things happen in life or when you're going through hardship, it's always important to focus on gratitude and focus on what you do have. And, you know, for me, like, I've been places in life where I felt like I lost everything. And the gratitude in me just says, well, what do I do have? I have a voice that can sing. I have, you know, a body that I have, a mind that can think. And even that, just kind of looking, it's the focusing on what you do have and the possibility in life, because like you can't focus on everything in life, right? And what you do focus on controls your whole mindset, in my opinion. And if you focus on the negative and the challenges and how big those obstacles are, that's all that, you know, your brain is going to see. And it's gonna fill you. Like I said, you can't focus on everything at once. And just focusing on the positive things will lead you down that path. Like you work through things in your life, you know. And you have to solve the problems in your life. And like writing songs, you know, if you go through and like, I'm not inspired right now, so many things are going wrong. And it's like, that's the mental space.
If you keep telling yourself that, you'll start to believe it.
So. You start to believe it. But if you just believe, like, there's a way, I know I can write another good song that I think is good, you know. I know I can do it. And if you think that, you know, you believe it, your brain will find a way to solve that problem. So it's really just, and the subconscious of like, just sleeping on it and things like that. Like, those thoughts are so important. So that's why I really think that it's all positive, and sadness is totally a part of life, and grief and all of those emotions. And it's important not to just block those out, but to understand and fully be aware of them, but not let it control your whole perspective, because you know, what you focus on is the direction that your life is going to take, in my opinion.
There's always a silver lining. I really relate to a lot of what you're saying, because my path to Nashville came after kind of a very large period of losing everything. And now I'm, you know, happier and more whole than I've ever been. And that, you know, that came after a lot of loss. And so I definitely can relate to that. And also everybody can relate to the fact that this last year and a half was really, really difficult. Yeah. There was a lot of loss, but I've also seen a lot of people find the silver lining in taking that time to really focus inward and do a lot of healing that they had not had time or the mental, you know, capacity to do in the past. And that's, everybody's better for it. You know, all the people who were able to do that.
Yeah.
That's the secret to Zen, right? Zen is understanding everything about yourself and also understanding that the whole development of who you are, including the shadows, the light, all of it is an encompassing version of the highest version of yourself. Mm-hmm. So it's only till I realized that too, like, you got to embrace your emotions, you got to embrace the highs and the lows. And you talking about the mind thing, right? Your mm-hmm. mind is so powerful. I think it's a really good example. This story I read a while ago, this woman was so convinced, like, she wanted to have a baby so bad. And she was like, I need to get pregnant. She couldn't get pregnant. Mm-hmm. Well, this woman literally convinced herself that she was pregnant. 9 months goes by. She's displaying symptoms of having a baby. It's like, there's one in her. And the doctors are like, you convinced yourself that you were pregnant. Like, the power of your mind is so powerful. To touch base, though, about you leaving stuff behind, you were talking to us about your engineering job.
Oh, yeah.
That you left behind in 2020. And you want to tell everyone a little bit about that and kind of how that shaped you as an artist and a person?
Yeah, absolutely. So my plan was, you know, to work in engineering until I could save up enough money to, like, build a home studio and then take the time off of work to record. And it ended up, like, looking at the silver lining of COVID, I ended up gaining a lot more time than I would have otherwise.
Right. It's kind of magical in certain ways.
Yeah. And yeah, I just, you know, left that career path that I had been going down in manufacturing engineering. But, you know, it was, and you were talking about this too with your music, is that there was this dying need to get the music out. So I left that career path, and I would like to go back to it eventually if needed, and, you know, for the money. But it's, you know, leaving the security and the, you know, benefits and everything of, like, a regular job path and all the progress that you make in a career is a risk. But, you know, in life, I think that you got to risk it.
You got to risk it to get the biscuit, people.
You got to risk it to get the biscuit.
A buttered biscuit.
And not doing that for me. You got to also look at the risk within the opportunity cost of not going off on your own.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's science, right? Every action has a reaction. And even if it's a decision to change your life, no matter what you do, you know something's going to come out of the end of it.
Yeah.
Speaking of a risk, though, Jenna, I think it's your turn to take a risk. And we, by the way, for those of you that have been keeping up with Fun and Games, which is probably all three of you, we haven't knocked down the Jenga tower yet. We've gotten close, but we haven't. So we're, it's not like we're pushing for it, but.
This is the toughest one yet.
It's a tight pack.
There we go.
Our producer Gerard's over in the back looking like, knock it, knock it. He's an avid fan of wanting to knock the tower over.
Might be going in that salsa. All
right. okay, so Sonny, we're kind of talking about your past, the things you've done, what's kind of built you. Can we expect any music videos? I know your TikToks are giving me life. Can you do your intro, your Sonny?
Oh, yeah.
I want to see it.
Yeah. It's like, well, the thing is on the phone. So it's like, welcome back to this week's episode of Sunsets with Sonny. Oh. What do we got?
Was it your
today?
Niece who did that?
Yeah, that was actually my cousin.
Oh my God. Yeah. She did it.
Yeah.
So perfect. Like,
yeah, that was really cute.
Yeah.
she's my youngest, shout out to my cousin Caroline. She's my my youngest like cousin, and she's 11, but we always go up, and she lives in Boston. We go up and visit them a couple times a year, and it's cool because I love kids, and I have a very childlike personality.
Same.
Where kids just want to have fun.
Yeah,
you know, and I love that about kids, that they just, you know, they're not caught up in all the bullshit. Like, you're just like, let's play.
And they're honest.
Yeah, and they're honest.
Yeah.
And so she's like,
they're just
the
looking
kid
for happiness.
Yeah.
That's all they care about.
Yeah.
What's gonna make me happy?
And they have so much energy.
Yeah. Yeah. I know, it's crazy. So, and I like to live my life like a kid. Like, I just wanna have fun. You know, it's a great way to live life, because, you know, all the pressure and everything just comes, and like, that can squelch creativity. You know what I mean? Pressure of like, oh, I gotta do this, gotta do that. Oh, gotta perform well at this show. Da, 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 da. And that, all that pressure, like, whether it's self-imposed or whatever, can like squelch your ability to be creative and also just to have fun. And that's what people want to see when you're performing. I think people want to see you having fun, and you want to have fun in the studio too. You want to, music should be fun. It's like, I was telling a friend of mine that too.
That's like, something that's like so kind of unique to creative industries, and specifically the music industry, is that it's so important to prioritize having fun and enjoying things, because otherwise you're not going to be creative. You have to be able to give your mind the freedom to be able to have the pressures off so that you can create. And I've recently moved to Nashville and been surrounded by creatives, where in the past I was living a pretty, you know, traditional life. And that's such a huge, it's such an impactful difference living here, surrounded by people who understand that and who just, yes, that's the way this industry works, is you have to take your personal days. You have to go do things that you enjoy, because if you don't, then you're not going to be able to create. And that's the most important part of your job.
To bounce on your subject of kids, though, I think it's very interesting. The reason kids are so creative is because they don't create for money.
Yeah.
Right? They're clout. Doing it just. They don't create because they want to impress their friends. They're just like, I'm creating because I just want to like do this. Yeah, this is fun to me. Like when they don't care about like the rhythm of something they're doing. Like you play music with a kid and you never hear like, dude, you're off note. Or
I know.
They just care. Kids are just
you're just doing it for fun.
Paint, do this. Yeah. They don't care about that stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm always telling people, when I always try to get my friends and everybody to sing, and I love singing with people. Like I always got my roommates back in Philly to sing with me the Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young song, Helplessly Hoping.
I love how your face demeanor changed right when you started singing.
Nearby. Shout out to Pat and Dom. If you guys are listening, like, I would always be like, come on, let's sing. And Andrew too. Let's sing. Andrew. Come on, let's sing. And then they're like, oh no, like I can't sing. And that's like my least favorite thing to hear somebody say. I've gotten to the point where I'm like, please just promise me you will never ever say that ever again, because
guilty of saying that.
Never say never.
Never say that you can't sing, because
had it right.
First of all, it's like programming your mind so that when you do go to sing, then that thought's gonna pop back in your head, I can't sing. Yeah. And then it's gonna, you know, it's not just like putting your hands on the guitar and playing. You gotta have the mind body connection to be able to think that you can sing. I think that's why a lot of people drink too sometimes when they want to sing, or like karaoke nights. People get hammered and then like will sing their heart out because
liquid
it just
courage.
It
makes
courage.
You forget about the things, the walls. The walls come down.
And if you, I always say this too, if you ask a first grade class how many people can sing in this class, everybody's going to raise their hand.
And they all sing better than each other. In fact, they will all compete as to who is the better singer.
Yeah.
Speaking of competing, it's my turn.
Nice.
Here we go.
So while she's doing that, I cannot currently sing. However, it is my bucket list to take lessons and practice enough to get myself to the point where
Gerard's face.
He's like, trying to blow it over.
He's like, knock it over.
To get myself to the place where I can communicate which song I'm talking about, where people can understand what song I'm trying to hum or sing, and they get it. Because right now it's like, I'm so tone deaf. I don't even know what song I'm trying to.
Well, you gotta stop saying that, Jenna.
It's on my list. Before the pandemic hit, I was actually already reaching out to vocal coaches for when I moved here, so that I could start taking lessons. And then, you know, everything got all messed up, and my priorities got all changed around.
Well, something also that I realized making music now, if fully embracing the artist self, is that you sometimes have to find your voice, right? Mm-hmm. Like you have to sometimes explore. I've realized in life a lot of things is finding out what you're not the best at to realize what you're really good at. Mm-hmm. And like when I first started singing, I was like, you know, I'm going to be a rock singer. Like I'm going to sing all my songs rock. And then I did that jazz show where I started singing jazz, and I sung and I was like, oh my God, I think I'm like a jazz indie singer.
Nice.
And I started singing all my songs that way. And I was like, this is a whole new level. Right. And I accepted the raspiness. Like my voice will be very raspy. And for a while I was like, oh my God, my voice isn't clear. And then people were like, no, dude, like people die for that kind of
work. Sounds
great. Yeah, like that sounds really great. So I think that's a whole part of it too, is like accept, kind of like you, to circle back to what you're saying, accepting your flaws and embracing them and being like, maybe like for a while, I thought I was so weird. I was like, you're the weirdest person in the freaking world. And then after I was like, wait, you're the weirdest person in the freaking world, which means you're unique and you're cool.
Stand out.
And that's, I think that's the mindset is so, so different in that. So Mr. Sonny, let's talk about, so you got some stuff coming up. What shows can we expect that people can see you at? Cause when this airs, it'll be airing next Wednesday.
Okay.
So where can people find you? Like if they want to come out and meet you. And...
Okay, cool. Yeah. I'm playing at, I'm playing solo at Donaldson Pub.
Oh, is that for Invisible Ink? Is it, what is that for?
That's for a writer's night on a Monday.
Oh, on a Monday.
Okay. Yeah, I'm looking to, I'm talking to them about playing with a full band too.
Ooh.
And
do you have a local band or are you still?
Yeah, yeah, I have a local band here of just, you know, friends and people that I've assembled. That are playing with me, and it's been really fun. Yeah, it's the Avengers. It's my Avengers. Yeah, it's really fun. And that's one of my favorite things is playing with the band live. Like I love to play by myself, but to get to have everybody play together is really awesome.
We want to catch you at Sonny's because I mean you're
I know even saying that.
Yeah, it's like I've been telling us you got to come to that Sonny's Tuesday thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
That would be like a really good. Show idea, like Sonny's the Sonny's. Okay, so it's your turn to do the Jenga, and also you haven't taken a bite of your cupcake, and I'm
sending
because
of that. Wait, we have to light the candle.
Oh yeah, we have to light the candle. Okay, we'll sing a little happy birthday if you're sitting at home singing along. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Sonny. Happy birthday to you.
All right, I'm making a wish. This is my first birthday wish of the day.
This is our first birthday song on Fun Games.
Yeah, this is it. This is my birthday cake.
Well, make cake. You got to make a good wish. Make a good wish because they count. Those go into the universe, okay?
I know. That's what we were talking about.
It goes in there. It goes and someone's taking it. Now you got to take a bite but close to the mic.
Okay, here we go.
While you take
it. This isn't going to be... Yeah, you're going to have to try hard to make this ASMR.
Smack your lips while you do it.
Mmm, yum. It's very moist.
Closer, closer, closer.
Here we go.
Act like you're kissing that thing. Perfect. How does
all
it
right.
taste?
I hope you got some of that. I hope y'all can hear it. It tastes delicious.
Good.
The buttercream icing.
I'm gonna have one.
It's perfect.
Say, yeah.
Definitely have one.
Yeah.
These are delicious.
Let's get some cupcake. Let's share some cupcakes in this building.
Here we go.
My Aunt Mary always.
I'm just gonna lick the icing off like I always do.
Yeah,
my
Aunt Mary,
ever since I was a young kid, always made me chocolate peanut butter cake. And next time I go home back to Lancaster, I'm definitely getting a rain check on that chocolate peanut butter cake because I can't pass that up.
Oh, she made like a special recipe?
It is a special recipe. It's called Wacky Cake. And there's actually coffee in the chocolate cake. And it's extremely moist. And the peanut butter icing on top, it's almost like a brownie almost. And the more days that pass, like if it's overnight, it just gets more moist.
The more sunny days that passed?
Yes. The longer it sits in the fridge, like the better it gets. It's crazy.
This cake is really, it's really good. Okay, so it's your turn, Sonny. You have to do the Jenga. And if you put your finger on a piece, you have to take that piece out. That's
okay.
So well, I broke that rule when I went, but...
Okay, that's the
rule.
We
won't tell anybody, but everyone that's watching.
So. Okay. Now that I know that that's the rule, I'm going to try to get this
one. This is going to be a difficult rule
I'm
for
looking.
This,
I'm really looking at which ones are, like, loose pieces. And I picked one.
Oh, yeah,
I got
you
it
got
right.
it.
Got it right.
Nice.
Oh, that was
a little bit
so
of overhang.
Close.
I almost dropped it.
Okay, guys, so we have a little bit of more time, just a bit enough time to talk to you a little bit more about your second album. So you said you're kind of writing it right now.
Mm-hmm.
I want to know a little bit about, like, your writing process in terms of, like, because I know everyone's different. Actually, we talked about this just a little bit ago before the cameras were rolling, that everyone's writing process is different. So, like, kind of what is the perfect ideal situation for you to write a song?
The perfect situation. That's a great question. The perfect situation is... to have the idea for what the song is and then craft the music around it and be inspired in some way or just have a really good idea for a song and then really create the music around that. But how it usually works is I come up with the music first, and then, like, it kind of just happens at the same time. Like, I will usually get it, like, start thinking of lyrics while I'm playing the guitar and sing along. Like, when I'm writing, I'm usually playing the guitar and singing at the same time. And then I will go through with a fine-tooth comb and try to spice it up and make it, you know, more poetic and change out the words and everything. But yeah, I usually write in real time as I'm playing. So I always have the pen and paper and the guitar in my hands usually. And then it's after that I really will go through and make the lyrics better, essentially, I guess. But the ideal thing, which is what happened with the song The Comet, I was inspired with this idea that, like, I was getting over a breakup, and then I had met this other girl that, like, you know, was, like, fell in love with or whatever at first sight, blah, blah, blah. And then it, like, even though she was, like, leaving town, like, 3 days after, I still felt, like, so much better because it, like, helped me get over that other relationship. And, like, that was in my brain about the kind. This is the only time that this has happened so far with a song that I've recorded, is that I had that idea, and then from that melody, from that idea came the melody, like this superhero anthem. She was the comet, you know, a spirit so bright. Like, so that's the ideal situation, because that song just, that was like the quickest song that I ever wrote. And I had, like, I had the great idea for it. It was kind of fresh, like the feeling was still there. And
that helps with the momentum. Yeah,
that helps with the momentum. And there are a lot of songs, I'm sure, that you guys know about this as well. Like, you lose the momentum of the song, and you lose the feeling, and before you really got it down, set in stone. Yeah. And then you can never get back to it because it's just not as powerful, and there's not as much motivation and emotion there behind the song. And you can muscle through it if you need to, you know?
Yeah, and a lot of times two melodies come to you, like, randomly. Like, you'll have a melody come to you, and you're like, and that's all I got.
Right. Well, yeah. But there's something really special about feeling all the feelings at that moment and getting the thought all the mm-hmm. way out, you know?
Yeah.
Before it disappears.
Yeah. I like, that's why I like voice memos, because I'll have melodies that come up, and I'm like I wrote one the other day, I was like, and I'm like singing it, and then like a couple hours later, I was like, what was I singing? And then I go back to the voice memo. I'm like, yeah, I got it. I saved it. Like, remembered
it. Yeah.
Because it went away.
Yeah.
So we're winding down. We're pretty much out of time. This just went by really fast. We didn't knock over the Jenga tower. So you're going to have to tune in again to see one day if we might.
We need to get better at this time management situation with the Jenga tower. I
know. Well, when you're playing fun and games, sometimes you have a little bit more fun than you do in the game. But Sonny, you want to go ahead and tell everyone where they can find you online? We'll link stuff below, but if you want to let everyone know where they can.
Yeah. Definitely follow the Spotify, follow the Apple Music. I got new music coming your way this fall. Working on those new tracks and working on a second record right now. And a lot of the music's written. And yeah, I'm looking to record it in studios here, right here in Nashville, and take that next step. So yeah, the Spotify, my Spotify is Sonny Dayes. That's SonnyDayes, if it's not probably on the title of the video that you're already watching. And then yeah, my Instagram, Sonny Dayes. Go to sunnydayes.com, check out my website if you want to buy some sweet merch. Don't have any here with me, but yeah, check it out on sunnydayes.com. Yeah. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Got the Instagram, don't have Twitter yet, but yeah.
And you'll be catching him with us a lot more. We're going to be doing a lot more fun stuff together, shows, woo! Events, things like that. But yeah, once again, guys, we're the Underground Music Collective, and we will be back to see you guys another episode next week.
Thanks a lot for having me. What's up? My name's Sonny Dayes. This song's called The Comet. She was the comet, a spirit so bright. In a beautiful moment, she lit up my night. I'll always remember
dog anymore, even though she's alone on in the morning. It seemed that new flowers had grown in my heart. I believe I've got light in my soul for the time I'm alone, but I'm fine on my own. I've got 7 long years till the comet returns. I'll be waiting for her golden stardust to come, flying out of the darkness and into my arms. But for now, I'll remember the night she was the comet, a spirit so bright. In a beautiful moment, she lit up my night. I'll always remember the shimmering light, the night that the comet flashed through my life. She told me of Jupiter, Mars, and Pluto, how they inspired her to write songs and poems. And she told me of Sam's love for Master Frodo, how a true friend is someone who never gives up, who will always be there for the ones that they love through the darkness and battle with fire and wolves. Like Sam carried him up, now you might carry her up the mountain. She climbs in the sky. She was the comet, a spirit so bright. In a beautiful moment, she lit up my night. I'll always remember the shimmering light, the night that the comet flashed through my eyes.
Thanks, everybody. Well, this song's called Bluebird, and my name is Sonny Dayes. Not warm enough. We'll see you later, everybody. Have a great day.